Hey, welcome back to another video. We did Chug and Astro.
We have all the stuff we need to make my experimental DIY AC system for the mini camper. I bought this for $136 off Amazon used. Standard cooler. So here's my basic idea. I'm gonna have this cooler somewhere above this refrigerator. I'll then have one radiator in this refrigerator and the other radiator inside this cooler with the fan blowing air through the cold fins and ultimately blowing out cold air. The reason I have it in here is because this will condensate and this will be catching out of the water. And it'll keep this cold while it's in here. And of course, I need a pump to pump the fluid throughout the whole unit. So first things first, I'm going to attach this inside here. To do so, I need to cut a hole as big as this fan. All the products and stuff I use in this video will be listed down below in case you want to try to experiment with something yourself. And if this works, you might want to copy it. Keep the dogs on the balcony like half the day. I want to take a moment and give appreciation to where appreciation should be given. And I actually got the basic idea of this from Make Everything off of YouTube. He's basically doing a similar but different idea within one cooler. Very smart stuff. Made the holes just big enough to fit this blade. You ever wonder what's in a cooler like this? You have a looks to be closed cell phone. All right now, we made a perfect hole, flawless. Now let's see if this fits. Right on, that's exactly what I was hoping for. Now we need to drill holes out for these guys. There's probably a really good mathematical way to figure out where these holes are gonna be. I'm just gonna eyeball it. Because why not? I highly recommend you be careful, take it easy, wear some gloves, some safety glasses, all that good stuff. Press them to the hole. When you're trying to put pressure on the radiator, do not put your fingers on the fins. You wanna put it on the outer edges. The air blows this way, so I'm gonna attach it just like so. To keep all this in place, I will be using washers. This wire is creating too much of an interference here. I'm simply gonna create an opening like that on the other side. Could have been a lot nicer. So much better. Okay. I now have this cheaper Chinese brand water pump. I was thinking I'm gonna install it about right there. These would be the bolts I'll be using to attach it. Pretty straightforward so far. Now, let's test out if this water pump works. There's water in it from the last person that used it. This is used. Bought these to connect to my DC to AC plug. You add the positive to the positive and the negative to the negative. Now here's the DC to AC converter. Just gonna plug that in right there. I don't know everything about electricity, so if I mess up, might have to use one of these guys. That works. Okay, so I can control how fast it goes. That's why I got this. I was honestly a bit nervous. I don't know all the ins and outs of converting AC to DC. All I know is I got the right amperage and volts and all that stuff. I'm not gonna add water to it in a very rudimentary way. I'm just gonna pour this water in here. Gonna turn it on a little bit. Pushing this way, I didn't think about that. It's not fully bled. I'm honestly not sure how I'm gonna bleed it, but it works. You can have it on the lowest setting. So far, everything's working to plan. That's a good thing. All right, here's some water. Here's some coolant. Don't drink the coolant. The starting temperature on both, they're both in the fridge since this morning. 39.2 and 39.8. Let's test it every 5 minutes.
53.8, 51.4, 55.4, 53.2.
I do not need to do any more of this test to know whether or not coolant keeps its temperature better than water. It doesn't, and that could very well be marginal, as in like room for error. Let's see what tastes better. This is a 12 volt compressor style fridge that can get down to what it says, -5 degrees. I tested it throughout the night and the bottom half of the chiller only got down to 10 degrees. And I'm thinking that's because the coils that chill the fridge are, is on the top third of the fridge. I still think that's a good deal for what I got this for. If you want to check out the review of this, it'd be on my other channel on Outline Motivate. I'll link that down below. So I'm gonna ultimately build a cabinet that's gonna enclose these two items if it works. This would be on the bottom where I can pull it out and still use it. So there's gonna be a little box surrounding this. Above said box be another box holding this sucker in. But I need enough piping to be able to pull out the fridge with it still connected. If this works and when I build the storage cap, I will be installing quick releases for this piping so I can pull out the fridge all the way if I need to. Be just like that. I sharpened on the end of this and then pressed it onto the fridge and it kind of made a very faint imprint. I'm now gonna make sure that that measurement is correct with my calipers. That works. That's a snug fit. Oh, and this drill bit that I'm using is a 1/2 inch. The lid is all air. Now we need to pump coolant through this. The way I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna uninstall these pipes here, get the coolant bottle, open up said coolant bottle, put the tube and the coolant bottle. Now suck on this tube. Coolant bottle, the coolant bottle, coolant bottle. Now suck on this tube. I'm kidding. I'm gonna use this. This pump is a self-priming pump, so theoretically, the air should not be an issue. But I'm also thinking, is it meant to run for a long period of time? I don't know. We'll find out, huh? If it fries up in the night. And the reason I'm using coolant is because the temperature should be getting below freezing. It should be. That's my goal at least. Plug the power strip in, just turn it on. Plug one thing in at a time. Turn on the fridge, it says 75. Is that -4 degrees? I was gonna set it to 1, so I feel better. I'm gonna let that cool down, get to about 30 degrees, then I'll turn on the whole system. I do wanna see if this fan works though.
That actually,
that feels good. Okay, I'll be back whenever that cools down a good bit. 85 degrees in this garage. The fridge is now at 5 degrees.
The van is currently 86 degrees.
Let's shut these. The fridge is currently pulling 48 watts. I'm gonna turn on the fan and see what temperature it is right now. That's reading 84 degrees. The line is kind of chilly, so let's go ahead and turn that on. 81 degrees. With the fan on low and the pump on low,
pulling 53 watts.
Not too shabby, not too shabby. I'm gonna be back in an hour. It's been 1 hour. And the temperature has not budged one bit. That's not good. And I think it might have to do with how much line is hanging out. So there's not much really in the fridge. I'm just pushing the hoses more into the fridge. I'll be back in another hour, see if this is gonna work. The temperature has not changed, so that didn't work. I think if there's more stuff in there that's cold, that was getting cold in the freezer, it would help get the radiator cold. So I got some frozen water bottles. I'm gonna go ahead and turn the fridge on. I'm gonna let that get to temperature, which should be fairly quick because there's ice in it now. It's already at like 68 degrees. It's been like a minute. 84 degrees in the van. Freezer is at like 25 degrees. Let's turn it all on. Got down to 72 degrees for my quick test. I'm gonna let that run for like, feels good. A whole hour. Be back in an hour. And I'm back. And does it work?
Technically. A tiny bit.
The air, it says it's 83 degrees. The fridge says it's 19 degrees. And the bottles in the fridge are still frozen.
Well, that didn't work as planned.
I have one more idea. That is involving,
some copper tubing. Currently, I have a small radiator in there, and I don't think that's enough surface area to get cooled down, to go through all this piping that is, you know, surrounded by rubber and into another radiator the same size. And I have high hopes for this. We'll see. We will see. My goal is to essentially wrap this copper tubing around the walls of this cooler. I did not buy the copper tube bender because this is probably the only time I'm ever gonna use this copper, and no way am I gonna spend over $50 for a tube bender that I'm gonna use once. This is harder than I was expecting. There has to be a better way. I got some flour from the kitchen. I don't even think it's flour, it's not all white. It might be wheat flour. I was gonna grab sand from outside, but it's raining. The one time in Texas it's raining out of like 4 months. Anyways, I'm gonna try to stuff all this in the fridge. So here's the deal. I have the other end capped off just like this. I'm now going to try to fill this entire copper tubing with that stuff. The flour is not going through the pipe as efficiently as I once thought. So I'm gonna cut this pipe into sections. Now you might be asking me, Chris, why did you just put a whole bunch of flour in that pipe? That's so I can bend it without a tube bender, without kinking it. Still created a kink. That's a big boy kink. I think the flour is just too soft. It's not working to plan. I'll be back. Okay. I bought a tube bender. There's one for sale for $15, and the one at Home Depot was not in stock and it's for $50. This one was $15. Yeah, that's so much nicer. So I'm marking how long I need these tubes with a Sharpie. And from my understanding, that mark should be at zero. And that's looking pretty decent. Let's continue. So I marked the length. Then I put that mark straight on zero. Then I bend the pipe. It is definitely worth buying a tube bender. As you can see, this is sticking way too far up, so I need to trim this. Get your trusty pipe cutter, mark your spot where you want to cut it, tighten it, and twist it. Once it gets kind of loose, you tighten it again. I probably have one more to do. I do not have a flaring tool, so I'm going to use needle nose pliers before and after. It's got a bit of flare to it. That's to hold the rubber tubing in place. Gonna fill it with coolant, then we test it out. Let's wait until that gets to zero and do our final test. If this doesn't work, nothing will. Yeah. 17 degrees, 81 degrees in the van.
The exhaust
is 87 degrees. Luckily, the exhaust doesn't seem like it's pushing out a whole bunch of temperature all throughout the van. That is a very cold radiator. Ooh. That is as cold as it's ever been.
Wow, that is actually cold air coming out.
63 degrees. I'll be back in about an hour. And we're back. It says 83 degrees in this van. I put it in the fan, it's 79 degrees. I'm gonna try one more thing, which might be a little silly and maybe a little crazy. So one of the big things that the guy did on the other YouTube video, he had a cooler with water and ice. And it's pumping the cold water from the water and ice directly through the lines. With the 5 bottles, we got the water. And half of the copper lines are surrounded with the water. So that means there's more cold stuff surrounding what needs to be cold.
Okay, so hovering at 77 degrees.
I'll be back in an hour.
76.
Okay, let's go. Be back in an hour.
It's been 1 hour later.
And when I opened up the door, it did feel a tad cooler. A little bit surprised.
not a huge difference.
The thermostat over here still says 83 degrees. But where I'm standing right here actually feels really nice. This sucker is reading 82 degrees and the air coming out is 71 degrees.
Very cold water in here. I think it would make a bigger difference if all the pipes were underneath the water.
I think for the way it's set up right now, it worked just fine as a personal AC unit. The water made a huge difference on how well it's performing.
Could it be better?
Of course, and there's probably a better way to do it. The way the other dude created it, pumping ice cold water directly through the lines, is by far the best way, but my issue is I just didn't want to buy ice. You'll still need to with this design, but it may just last a lot longer than his design. If you have any ideas on how to make this better, let me know down below. I'm all ears. I'm willing to make it work if I can. I would do a test throughout the night, but I don't want to spend another day on this video because I need to get out to y'all. It's been about over a week since I started this video. So I apologize. Yesterday, I actually went to look at a project car. We scheduled it for 1:30. Told them ATA was at 1:30. They replied with saying, oh, hey, I actually got caught at work. I'm so sorry. I'll be free at 3:30. So I started to leave for 3:30, told them my ATA. They said, oh, shoot, I'm not off of work yet. I said, oh, I'm sorry. I thought you said you're free at 3:30. So then I asked for a time to meet. They said 4:30. Guess what? When I got there, I said, hey, my name's Chris. They said, oh, hey, sorry, I sold the car yesterday. I drove out of my way, scheduled my whole day to meet this person, and they sold the car the day before after we've been talking all day? What the heck? I had to rant a little bit on that. I want to say thank you to my patrons for making these videos possible.
Thank you for all of y'all for sticking with
me. This is Chris Bills and I always appreciate and respect one another. I'll see you next time.
The lid is made out of ABS plastic. It's pretty grippy, so I kind of like that. The controls are right here. Might as well just